Below the Tropic of Cancer in southern Taiwan, an ambitious fish farmer wants to farm cold water fish in a subtropical climate.
减少食物里程对这块土地就是一种友善的态度。
In the countryside of Malaysia, young drone pilots join forces with aging farmers to revamp traditional agriculture.
重点不是在取代了老龄化的劳力，而是把农业上面的知识进行数据化。
Outside of Taipei, a revolutionary compost plant turns food waste into fertilizer to restore soil fertility.
It is the world's only technology that can turn organic waste into fertilizer within 3 hours.
These transformations are made possible by smart technologies, using both artificial intelligence and the Internet of Things.
Smart agriculture is the future of agriculture.
The consumption of food shapes its production. In air, land, and sea, innovative Taiwanese farmers, scientists, and engineers are at the helm of a global movement to revolutionize not only agriculture, but our planet's future. It's 6 in the morning, just outside Talu Intan, a city in Perak State, Malaysia. The next generation of agricultural recruits has started working. Among them is Abajunaidi bin Jamil, a 22-year-old from Langkawi. Final checks done, off he goes with his teammates to begin the day's work.
We're going to field and set up the drone.And start flying the alpacas at 7:15.
Abed and his team are agricultural drone pilots.
We do spraying for paddy. We'll cover like 18 to 20 hectare per day. With drone, you just need 10 to 15 minutes to cover 1 hectare.
Traditional manual spraying takes 30 to 40 minutes in comparison.The drone team is run by Malaysia's agricultural agency, FELCRA, short for Federal Land Consolidation and Rehabilitation Authority.
FELCRA developed this abandoned land, which we turned into oil palm plantation, rubber plantation, and also paddy.
Perak State is the rice bowl of Malaysia.But its future is far from certain.
I was born in this area. This is our asset. Our asset belongs to our family.
Daniel, a landowner, returned to the village in his retirement. His late father and grandfather were local farmers, but his age makes it all but impossible for him to farm his land himself.
My kids, to study overseas or to study here.Now everybody all out already.
The aging farming population and labor shortage plague not only the village, but all of Malaysia, threatening its vital food supply.
Our self-sufficiency level for rice is 69%, which means 69% is being produced locally and 31% is being imported.
Malaysia has some of the biggest paddy fields and oil palm plantations in the region, but its crop yield struggles.
The highest I remember is only 5 metric tons.
在台湾，我们大概一起稻作，我们的一甲地的产量啊，约莫大概在12-13公吨。所以他们也非常希望至少能够跟台湾是一样好。
Malaysia targets an 80% rice self-sufficiency rate by 2022.One of FELCRA's top priorities is to increase yield sustainably, and it is betting on new technologies like drones.
Since last year, we started to collaborate with a Taiwanese company through Mata Aerotech to further increase the efficiency of our plantation.
This company's name is Mata. M-A 代表马来西亚，T-A 代表台湾。 主要目的啊，就是引进台湾 GeoSat 技术，把它运用在马来西亚当地。
Headquartered in Taiwan, GeoSat Aerospace and Technology designs and builds these drones for agricultural use. The Mata team begins with automated crop spraying. Depending on the season, the drones can be used to spray pesticide or fertilizer. The technology was a success in Taiwan. Now, the team needs to deliver the same result in Malaysia.
这边的土地它都是比较大片，整个应用无人机的作业效率啊，可能是台湾的好几倍。那它所需要培养的这个飞手啊的人数啊，远超过我们在台湾以往的经验。
GeoSat does not limit itself to spraying operations. It also runs a pioneering pilot training program. Kenny Chong, a retired Air Force colonel, oversees the training of this new class of pilots.Abid is one of them.
Studying at College Fekra in diploma in agriculture, Mata Yorata offered me to join this program. My dad is a Fekra manager. When I saw him do his work, gave me a passion to in agriculture sector.
In a couple of days, Abid and his classmates will have their skills evaluated. Those who pass will receive a formal job offer from Mata.
Agriculture is a not glamour career path for the younger generation. By using technologies, we attract the younger generation to involve with this traditional agriculture.
It's worked.
We very enjoy flying the drone. When we use gadget and technologies, this can make young people interested in agriculture.
After a short lunch break, work resumes at school.
目前这个学员的训练啊，我们一开始是先让他用电脑模拟来操作的训练。第二个阶段就是我们的进阶训练。第一个要做一些基本的手动的航线飞行。那第二个部分就是要学习怎么操作地面操控站的一个软体程式。经过考核之后，我们就会拉到田野间去做实际上的整合训练。
One team have 2 person, which is one pilot and one co-pilot. The pilot will flying the drone, and the co-pilot will do mapping for the drone fly.
To optimize efficiency, flight routes are pre-programmed. The pilot controls takeoff and landing.Once the drone reaches a designated height, the automated flight mode kicks in, and the drone follows a programmed path set and evaluated by the co-pilot. Alpas 2 can fly beyond the line of sight using GPS tracking. It possesses a secret that makes its crop spraying even more effective.
单轴直升机主要靠一个主螺旋桨产生这个升力，间接的产生一个很强大的下起气流。
These rotor blades generate a powerful aerodynamic whirlwind that pushes the spray down toward the crops. Drone spraying has gained rapid acceptance in recent years as farmers realized its numerous advantages over traditional methods.
First one is cost.
用无人机所耗用的农药量啊，就是人工量的一半左右，可以大幅降低整个农药的使用量，对这个环境呢、啊、也更友善一些，然后提高我们的产量。
Drone technology will help reduce cost, reduce labor, and work faster and more efficient.
Adopting drone technology will provide Malaysia with a simple method of achieving higher crop yields.But the highly specialized drones used by the Mata team in Malaysia are not a result of simple innovation. Alpas 2 took more than 4 years to develop, and its creators are constantly improving it. Inside GeoSat's factory in Taiwan, an Alpas 2 is being assembled. GeoSat's founder and CEO, Dr. Cheng Fong Lo, an expert in aerospace technology, knows how to give modern drones their edge.
It's a very beautiful material.所以它整个很轻，可能就只有几十克到几百克，但是它的强度是钢的三倍。首先是新材料，因为它需要节省能源，需要把自己的减重能够飞行的时间更久。 第二个呢，无人飞行载具在飞行的过程里面，又要靠它自动控制，我们建立了我们自己的大脑。
The brain of Alpas 2, the transmission module, sits inside the main chamber. The camera on its nose and the GPS on its tail provide precise real-time aerial imaging. The spray tank, attached to the underbelly, carries a 16-liter payload. Two electronic pumps with four spraying nozzles sit on both sides of the skid legs. The main rotor blades are made of fiberglass for lightweight and durability. Alpas 2 can fly up to an hour while enduring scorching temperatures and corrosive chemicals.
跟人的传统的喷洒来比较，在某些国家像马来西亚已经有60倍的效能，所以它可以大幅的解决人力的短缺。其实重点不是在取代了老龄化的劳力，而是在它的资料收集的过程里面，把农业上面的知识进行数据化，转成是一个不需要入门门槛很高的工作。
Data collection using state-of-the-art technology, in particular artificial intelligence, allows GEOSAT to gain insights into agricultural management.
特别是极端气候底下，因应未来的人口，你必须对于防疫或是它的生长管理，要进行做最有效率的数据管理，在有限的面积，将它的产能能够提升。
Increasing crop yields while mitigating climate change is a balancing act. In Malaysia,Getting the balance right has real ramifications. Malaysia is the world's largest palm oil exporter. Palm oil is widely used in industries from processed food to pharmaceuticals. But the deforestation caused by ever-expanding oil palm plantations is alarming.
不是田地面积不够，而是我们没有好管理。让它的效率提高，那它不需要去扩展更大的田地的面积。
The Malaysian government has pledged to cap its oil palm plantations at 6.5 million hectares by 2023. Felcra is relying on technology to practice sustainable plantation management to meet the pledge, starting with an accurate oil palm tree count.
因为事实上，棕榈树这种东西在马来西亚，它种植的面积是非常非常大。是我们用大规模航拍之后，你就可以看到说，我这边事实上我还可以再补足，或者是这边是种植过密。我们最开始用无人机大量的就拍照片，那结合一些 GPS 跟 IMU 的资料，我们就可以把这些照片做拼接，而且知道每一棵树在哪边。
Pterosaur, a lightweight drone, is deployed for the assignment. Weighing only 2.2 kilograms, Pterosaur boasts up to 70 minutes of airtime in one charge. Depending on the assignment, it can be fitted with either a 24 million pixel camera, an infrared camera, or a multispectral sensor. For an area of 513 hectares, Dr. Chang received more than 1,700 aerial photos. After stitching them into a map,The AI model was able in merely an hour to decipher the total number of individual trees, 68,559. The team then verified the data by counting them manually. It took 5 to 6 assistants nearly a week. Tree count scratches only the surface of AI application. GEOSAT has larger ambitions.
我们目前已经可以做到无人机飞到那个树的上空的时候，确认这是一棵棕榈树，那我就去做喷药，判别它有没有生病。这基本上还要再做更多的资料的收集。
These AI experts realize they need help with plant pathology, so Dr. Guang Yi Chan was brought on board to train machines to become more intelligent.She and her team first need to build a database of agriculture domain knowledge.
在一开始的时候，每一个物种它下面有很多不同的品系，全部都需要去收集3年的资料是最基本的。
Today, her team is collecting the data of sugarcane in southern Taiwan. Agricultural drones are deployed to collect the vegetation index. The index is computed using a multispectral camera.It measures the state of plant health using several spectral bands that are sensitive to plant biomass and vigor. Dr. Chan's team mostly use Optimized Soil Adjusted Vegetation Index, or OSAVI.
我们现在使用有5个波段， RGB 这是最基本的，然后还有一个 NIR， 还有就是 Red Edge， 这五个影像它就可以用来计算各种不同的支声指数。
Years of AI data collection in Taiwan have enabled successful crop yield predictions. Now, Geosat's team is helping Malaysia collect vegetation indices for its rice paddies and oil palm plantations.
我们可以把台湾当作一个研究基地，我们在台湾测试，如果是可行的，我们就推广到大面积的东南亚国家。
Dr. Tsai shares a similar view.
台湾是一个很好的练兵场。你可以收集到很多种作物的 data， 农业的研发单位都很强大，台湾在机电的整合还蛮领先的。那我们的无人机如果能够在台湾的田地飞得好，到国外的田地都不是问题。
Using Taiwan as a laboratory, these scientists continue to perfect the latest technologies and share them globally. Their work is bearing fruit. After 3 months of hard work,Abid and the young squad have passed the evaluation to become Malaysia's first generation of agricultural drone pilots. The commencement is an emotional moment. It marks a new era of productive, sustainable farming, not to mention opening doors for young people like Abid.
Now I'm one of the master staff.My dad also happy when I'm working in this sector. He said one day we will have our own company that supply drone service to other farmers so we can help them to increase their yield. I will work with my dad one day.
Marine environments are under immense pressure caused by overfishing and habitat destruction. Over the past 50 years, annual global consumption of seafood products per capita has more than doubled, and that number is expected to continue to increase with the world's growing population. Rising ocean temperature and ocean acidification further harm the declining fish population.While some see this as a lost cause, others are stepping up to the challenge.
Here, this fish can let you see. This fish, its tail, and its back are very soft. Oh, and this is only in very good conditions, it will show this color, this color. The fish is good or not, you can see the color.这块土地它需要洁净的大海，它需要这些更多的物种。野捞的鱼种已经越来越少了，而且越来越小。只要我们的养殖方法正确的话，其实我们可以不断的去供给。我非常有信心，我们养殖出来的鱼一定比野捞的更好吃。
Fish farmer Bo Young Huang's confidence is built on a stellar track record. Tainan.A city in southern Taiwan is known for its shrimp and milkfish farming. While other aqua farms typically farm only one or two species, Huang's fish farm is like a mini ocean.
我一个池子里面就养了十几二十种的物种，从掠食性的物种到上中下，底层的底栖的物种到甲壳类、贝类，甚至大型藻类，把它做成一个所谓的生物链的养殖方式。
The diverse fish farm mimics the natural environment, where only the fittest survives.
我一直秉持了一个理念呢，就是其实单一物种消耗单一元素，所以如果你一个池子只养单一物种的话，对这块土地其实是极度不友善的。
Aquaculture productivity is highly dependent on the natural environment. Huang hopes to offset the impact of food production by practicing sustainable farming.But warmer water temperatures, heavy rainfall, and severe weather caused by climate change have posed an unprecedented challenge to fish farmers around the world.
因为养殖业就是靠天吃饭。我们生产者现在这几年面到最大的问题就是极端气候。像我爸爸今年快80岁了，他都没有碰过说台湾的池子的温度会上升到35-36度。
Huang began farming fish only a decade ago.After he left his job in the high-tech industry to move closer to his aging parents. He is determined to reinvent an industry that has not changed much in the past 30 years.
We are not going to change the climate. 所以我们的做法就是去顺应天候，我们利用科技的力量，一样可以在这么极端气候的环境之下从事友善养殖。
To produce sustainable seafood products, Huang embraces technology and relies on big data to manage his farm. This LifeBuoy-looking gadget is AquaLink, a smart device that monitors a fish farm's water quality.
我大概在三年多前开始接触，当我看到这个水聚宝，我就很确定，它对养殖是有很大的帮助。
AquaLink sends real-time data such as temperature, oxygen level, pH, oxidation reduction potential, or ORP, and salinity directly to the farmer's phone.
这行做什么
？ORP 是啥意
思 ？ORP 是氧化还原。你像我这个囡仔向下落来，表示就是讲有机物伤多啊。我叫伊停了，困落落，啊，曲线落袂去。伊比氨氮、阿摩尼亚佫较早发现，基本上才两公啊。当有这个大数据的数字之后，我可以很明确的知道应该做什么处置。
水质的管理很重要，但是以往的人必须要亲自到池边用手持式的去测量，耗费相当大的一个人力。而且也没有办法24小时的去收集，所以这套系统也能够把它省略下来。原本可能需要派人到池边去测量水的这个工作，但是又能够得到更完整的数据。
Developed by AquaLink, a Taiwanese startup founded by Otto Tsai, AquaLink aims to make aquaculture smarter.
这个就是我们整个这套系统的心脏哦，这里面包括无线处理讯号的晶片。然后包括数位类比讯号的模组，包括供电的模组，养殖上面需要各种不同的数据，就会有不同的感测器。那收集每五分钟的数据，把它上传到云端。像这次感测器就是 pH 值，就是酸碱值的感测器。比如说强降雨的时候，会不会影响到水质，会不会过酸等等。那养殖户也需要及时知道。才能够有足够的时间去应变应用。
The four underwater sensors provide real-time data on the water quality.
水聚宝这套系统呢，除了放在水中不断的帮客户去收集累积数据以外，那我们的这些数据还会传到我们另外一组设备，叫做智能电箱，能够去启动远端的控制。
The smart monitor and control system on land can be operated using a mobile phone app, which can control aerators, pumps, or feeding machines.
像我们服务的一个客户黄国伟黄先生，他自己去开发整合的一套造流跟打气的设备，都能够装到我们的智能电箱上面来做控制。
AquaLink's smart platform enables trailblazers like Guo Liang Huang to test out more innovative farming methods.He is conducting a bold experiment.
鲑鱼养殖在我们台湾唯一的条件就是温度，只要有我们有能力达到这个温度，其实任何鱼都可以养。
As the global population is set to approach 10 billion by 2050, sustainable food production and consumption are the only ways to feed the world. Smart technology allows fish farmer Guo Liang Huang.To reinvent traditional aqua farming into a sustainable practice. But more than changing aqua farming, he wants to change minds.
电费哈，对我们而言是非常高的成本。一般人可能说，哎，那我去弄个所谓的节能水车，啊，减少个10%、20%。可是这对我而言幅度还是太小了。
Paddle wheel aerators utilize electricity to churn water briskly, thereby allowing oxygen transfer through air-water contact.
我们现在看到这台机器是我们自己研发的，我们只需要一个非常小的马达，那底下我们利用这个缓慢的叶片的转动，我们其实主要是利用叶片的角度去带动整个水体，我就开发了所谓的造流增氧机，它一分钟可以扰动800吨水体的，比大概6到8台水车都还多。
Churning the water is not enough. Huang also needs to find ways to increase the oxygen level. The solution? a pressurized pump to compress the air into nano-sized particles before releasing them into the ponds.
所以我们一个月以三分地来讲，传统的养殖方式，它大概需要架设六台水车，需要15,000到20,000块的电费。那我们只需要2,000块不到的电费，而且这个增氧的效能是传统水车达不到的。它节能的效率不是10%、20%，它甚至可以节能到90%、95%。
It is a daunting task to revamp a traditional industry and change people's minds.He hopes his experiment will help other fish farmers reduce costs and make aquaculture more eco-friendly. Before he can convince others, there's one person he needs to convince first.
刚开始我接触的时候，其实我爸爸他也非常担心我了，花了这么多钱买了这些设备到底要干什么？就是我会把手机拿去给他看，哎，这个东西怎么了？啊，发生了什么状况？对，他会慢慢勾引他的想法。其实我爸爸虽然年纪很大，可是他对这些新知识的吸收，他算是蛮开放的。他对这些东西他都是很愿意接受的。那今年会帮他加装一些设备在他那。
你
都
知影，
那阵他来顺利安尼。
Huang needs to persuade not only the older generation, but also the younger one as well.
其实我把科技带到养殖业来，不只是要去分担劳力而已，但是它最大的用处在于说，我们可以让年轻人觉得好玩。那当他来这里，来我这边工作的时候，之后发现说，哎，这个蛮有趣的，跟我们想象中的渔业跟农业是不一样的，而且真的未来可能会是个事业。
Huang and his team are using technology to conduct an audacious experiment. If they succeed, the marine environments will finally get a much needed break.
在台湾光进口鲑鱼啊、虾饼，一年的产值超过100亿，这些鱼都是在其他的国家养殖，坐着飞机到台湾来。
Huang attempts to successfully farm highly demanded cold water fish and shellfish.
我会想要在台湾养冷水鱼的原因很简单，减少食物里程。其实这对这块土地就是一种友善的态度。
The growing popularity of cold water fish like salmon is depleting the wild population at an alarming rate. Aquaculture has emerged as an alternative. Salmon live in temperatures between 8 to 14 degrees Celsius. Located below the Tropic of Cancer, Tainan is the last place for any sensible person to attempt to farm salmon and other cold water fish.But Huang has it all figured out.
这个就是我们用这个来监控它的 ORP 跟温度，因为温度是我所饲养的物种的绝对条件，所以我可以借 ORP 的监测数字，可以很清楚的知道我现在这里面的氨氮是不是在可控范围内。你看，鲍鱼，哎，鲍鱼在我们台湾哈，现在几乎没有人在养殖。那主要原因就是因为温度，因为鲍鱼它适合在24度以下的低温，要在台湾养鲍鱼又要在户外，水温条件又要达到，非常困难。所以我就是利用我们的冷却系统，我们现在这个水温都维持在大概24到25之间。那天气越热，它温度越低，我们就是利用非常自然的冷热交换原理，让它自然去转换。把水当中的热源蒸发掉，我们现在可以稳定操作的温度大概是从19到25之间，我们现在就计划要大规模的开始去饲养石鲷啊、真鲷甚至蚜饼这些鱼种。
His goal is to one day farm salmon, one of the world's most popular seafoods, in Taiwan.
鲑鱼养殖在我们台湾唯一的条件就是温度，只要有我们有能力达到这个温度，其实任何鱼都可以养。
Using modern Taiwanese innovations, farmers like Huang are reshaping the outlook of their industry by replicating imported seafood locally, reducing food miles, and allowing our oceans essential time to recover. Today's agriculture is a world apart from our grandparents' time. While industrial farming has brought more food to the table, many of its practices could compromise the health of the land that food is grown on. Farmer Guibin Shi still remembers when only organic fertilizers were available for farming decades ago.
When we were young, when we didn't have chemicals, we were really using organic. We were using fertilizers to feed animals.
It was organic farming in its truest sense, but it came with a huge drawback.
That time, the yield was very low. Until later, when we had chemicals,
The world's population is expected to grow at an annual rate of 81 million people, reaching 10 billion in 2050. In order to feed a growing population, synthetic fertilizers are widely used in modern farming to boost crop yields. They act like plant steroids that immediately supply essential nutrients to the soil. But, like steroids, synthetic fertilizers could have negative effects in the long run.
用化学肥它会伤到一些土质啊，它会造成我们土壤酸化。
Soil amendments like synthetic fertilizers not only accelerate acidification, damaging plants and organisms in the soil, they could also leach into groundwater and cause water pollution. The very agents used to increase food production may substantially decrease it over time.
施撒太多的农药造成我们食安的问题，我觉得也这样不好。政府在推这个有机友善耕作的时候，我们也积极加入。目前耕作的面积将近70公顷，大部分是水稻。Su's
commitment to organic farming allows for safe produce and sustained soil fertility. Slow-releasing organic fertilizers are less acidifying, but their higher cost may deter other eco-minded farmers from trying. But a few months ago, he had news of a windfall. He was told that bulk bags of top-quality organic fertilizer would be supplied to his farm at no cost.
张永基张老板他一开始的时候就来寻找我们产销班，说可以使用他们做出来的有机肥这样子。
It sounded too good to be true. He was skeptical. The organic fertilizer is produced in a newly built factory just minutes away from Shi's farm. It's 8 in the morning, and the workers are prepping the factory for another day's work.
This factory is 800平方公尺的一个厂房。机械设备部分都是我跟机械商研究、自己创新做出这相关的设备。
This facility is the first of its kind in the world. These blue buckets contain food waste collected by the city of Taoyuan. The factory composts the waste and turns it into organic fertilizer in a matter of hours, 3 hours to be exact. 250 kilograms of fertilizer is produced for every metric ton of food waste.
因为我本身是农业出身，对农业废弃物的处理，我是很感兴趣的。利用酵素处理可以短短3个小时内把这些厨余熟化变成肥料，这是一种是很了不起的发明。很好的地点可以采集。This
game-changing method is the result of groundbreaking work by Chung and his mentor, Dr. Chu Zhongyang, a renowned soil microbiologist.
我的兴趣是在土壤微生物及生化，就是专注在微生物肥料和有机物废弃物的处理。Composting
remains one of the most common ways of treating organic waste, but the method is problematic.
就传统的堆肥有三个问题，第一个时间很长，要3个月以上，甚至到6个月；第二个就是很臭、很脏，再过来要很大的空间。
Having succeeded in developing microbial fertilizers, Dr. Young wonders if he can accelerate the process while eliminating the odor issue.
微生物厌环子要靠时间，那我们要想办法缩短时间。
The answer turns out to lie not in the microbes themselves, but in what microbes produce, enzymes. Enzymes are proteins that act as catalysts. When one substance needs to be transformed into another, nature uses enzymes to speed up the process.
微生物是火的菌，这个酵素从哪里来？是从微生物分泌来的，酵素直接拿来用，不要靠微生物的繁殖来作用，对我们这个废弃物来处理，时间可以缩短非常多。
It took Dr. Young and his team 7 years to perfect the biodegradation method, which he named TTT technology. At TTT's Agrobiotech's headquarters, wastes are treated using different enzyme formulas.
So all these petri dishes are our, we have managed all sorts of different organic waste. For instance, this is a kitchen waste.And this is the bovine dung. Most of the waste we have already have the enzymes products for it.
Lee Sin Young, Dr. Young's son, is a scientist himself who left his university job to help his father realize the real world potential of his research.
在发展的时候有高度的困难，其中最重要就是菌种本身要找到好的菌种。分泌这个好的酵素，而且这酵素都要能够耐热、耐环境的储存。另外一个问题就是说，液体它很难保存。
When we get the liquid form of enzymes, we will transform into a solid form. After that, we will put in additives. The additives will stabilize the activity of the enzyme for at least 1 year.TTT technology is the world's only technology that can manage organic waste and turn it into organic fertilizer within 3 hours.
The enzyme formulations are ready for use. Having perfected the technology at the lab, the Youngs work with Yong Chi Chang to test its real-world application.
Yang Yuan Zi, he also agreed to give me the 酵素处理农业废弃物的技术寄转给我。从那个时候开始，就是我左手实物在操作。
Chang thought that there was hidden potential in one particular type of waste.
厨余，我觉得是未来一定要处理的。
But he did not expect an opportunity would come knocking on his door so soon. A growing population has produced more waste than ever before.Even though Taiwan has one of the highest recycling rates in the world, treating recycled food waste remains a big headache. Local governments have long scrambled to find ways to get rid of the mounting food waste.
桃园市的人口是225万人，每天厨余生产量大概是186公吨，那可以讲非常的庞大。我们市政府决定成立厨余的处理厂，用厨余来转换成为肥料。
因为厨余这一部分，我觉得是未来一定要处理的，所以我认为说必须要去做它。
In 2019, the city commissioned Chang to build this new compost facility to treat nearly 1/3 of Taoyuan's total recycled food waste.
很多人就跟我怀疑我，800平方公尺，你每天要处理60吨，甚至合约里面有提到节庆。之后量很多，必须每日要增加25%的处理量。我说可以，没有问题。
Chang managed to streamline the process, automate the production, and fit everything into a facility that is smaller than 2 basketball courts.
我是用堆高机将这个站板上面的9桶的厨余放上去我的工作平台，它是自动化进去，它感测到。我有东西载重的时候，它就自动往前进。
It's not the volume that poses a challenge, but the content. Liquid is drained from the kitchen scraps before they are sorted manually to remove non-food waste, like plastic bags and utensils. Rice hulls, sawdust, and organic additives are then added to the scraps to suppress odor, reduce water content, and balance the pH level during milling and mixing.
进到预拌槽里面去，我们会在这个时候添加酵素。一吨的要处理原物料，我加20公斤的这个酵素。
Inside, gas is used to heat up the mixture to activate the enzymes. Different substances have different heating curves and therefore require different temperatures. The mixture reaches 80 to 85 degrees Celsius in the bioreactor. This process not only ensures enzymes' performance, but also sterilizes the compost to avoid contamination.
因为有机废弃物的来源很复杂，我们不知道有没有对人有传播性的病原，所以这个时候为了安全起见，酵素作用完之后，我们要有一个灭菌的动作。
那一般的病原菌到80度的时候，有99%以上的病原菌都已经死亡了。杨院士他研发这个东西可以耐高温到90度。
After 3 hours in the bioreactor, the food waste mixture is turned into compost that is ready for use. The factory churns out 15 tons of organic fertilizer from 60 tons of food waste that it treats daily.
我们这个特性就是因为它是完全熟化的肥料，温度降低之后就直接可以用到田里面。我也希望说多做几场，不止在台湾做，在国外也要做。我希望把这推广到全球。
经过这个反复的验证，证明这个方法是有效的。早上厨余进来，那下午就可以产生有机肥料。那产生的有机肥料可以作为我们的稻米、蔬菜重要的这个肥料的来源，完全符合循环经济的道理。
Local farmers like Gui Ben Chi benefit directly from the end product.
我都会去找一些那个比较没有肥分的田呢，尽量去撒，哎，结果效果不错哎。我们人吃剩下的东西叫厨余，把它做成有机肥，再回归到大地里面去的话，当然是最好的啊。
As plant owner Yung Chi Chung is proving, the new compost method lessens the impact of organic waste while creating a sustainable business model.
我们用的种类很多，像屠宰废弃物啊，包括工厂的生物污泥也可以用这种方式处理。废弃物不要当成垃圾，再把它当成有效的资源再利用。
人类去利用土地，它是会退化的。全世界大概有1/3的地要靠有机质来拯救，变成我们用快速的技术才有办法大量的供应。气候变迁和我们有机质的循环非常大的关系。我们如果把这些东西储存在土壤里面，空气中的温室气体就可以减少，气候变迁暖化就会降低，土壤健康，植物就才会健康，我们食物才会健康，人类才会健康。
Our planet is facing unprecedented challenges of growing population and climate change.As agriculture becomes more important than ever, the survival of humanity tomorrow depends on rethinking our approach to food today. Retooling traditional farming with cutting-edge technology, creating ingenious innovations, and turning waste into a resource. Taiwan's experts combine the island's strength to bring solutions for food production, consumption, and waste management. The result?Can be a healthier, more sustainable island and planet Earth.